At the beginning of this course, when we started looking at the different tab sheets of the FAGUS interface, we saw in the geometry tab sheet a button called Result Combination. We mentioned that this would be explained in detail once we'd taken a look at shear, torsion, and longitudinal reinforcements. So let's now take a closer look at this function. For certain parameterized cross sections, we'll observe the identification Asw1, always next to the cross section. What this actually is a combination of results that provides us with information on shear reinforcement, hence the SW for shear wall, for a particular element of our transversal cross section. But what are these result combinations used for? Well, they allow us to combine certain values obtained from different result points. If you recall, we discussed result points in depth when we explained the FAGUS interface. So, we can combine those values obtained in the result points with values obtained from different elements of the cross-section, like, for example, shear walls. And this can be done using the formulas we'll see in just a moment. We'll also see that the combinations of results will be highly useful for our transversal reinforcements, since they will allow us to combine, for example, the result of a shear wall with the minimum steel reinforcement ratio. So the program will give us information on the minimum steel reinforcement ratio as well as on the transversal reinforcement of a given shear wall, but we'll have to make use of a tool that takes the highest value of those two that the program provides. That tool is result combination. Additionally, we know that to resist shear and torsion, we'll have to introduce several shear walls, and for each shear wall, as we've already discussed, we'll obtain some certain results that will ultimately end up in the availability of just one stirrup in the reinforcement. So the combination of results will allow us to process the information we have regarding shear and torsion, as well as information regarding the minimum steel reinforcement ratio, in order to put everything together and, thanks to some certain mathematical expressions, work with it all so as to obtain the information we require to design just one stirrup. In previous sections, we've observed a substantial group of cross-section types with the shear torsion models for which we had to choose model automatic, model type A, or type B. Remember that we used model A for box sections, for example, and model B was the classic model we needed to use for double T type cross-sections. Thus, the program, in all parameterized cross-sections, will already have certain information regarding ASW1. However, it's important to know how to access such information and, still more important, how to interpret it. This table shows four of the most typical cross-sections that we'll find in FAGUS. One rectangular cross-section, one T, one double T, and one circular cross-section. For all of them, the program will have a result combination it will call ASW1, which will have a certain formula associated with it. Let's briefly explain what this means and how it can be modified. For example, in a rectangular cross-section, what is the reinforcement we need in our stirrup? Here we see that the program will provide the reinforcement for this stirrup. On the one hand, as can be seen here, ASW1 would be the minimum steel reinforcement ratio, or in other words, ASW minimum for shear wall SWZ, or it could be the sum of the reinforcement corresponding to the shear wall that the program determined internally for torsion plus the reinforcement the program determined for our shear wall in Z, and likewise, that of torsion plus the reinforcement necessary to resist shear in Y. Similarly, how can we obtain the reinforcement necessary in this vertical element? This would be the minimum steel reinforcement ratio, the necessary steel reinforcement ratio, or that which the program proposes for the shear wall in Z, corresponding to our force VZ, and that our shear wall Z resists with regards to torsion, which is what we find here, plus that which is required to resist torsion. Logically, it will need the amount for both of them, or the minimum. We will see that there is a way to introduce this formula. The next example shows how we can get the reinforcement necessary in the web, which is the minimum steel reinforcement ratio, or that which corresponds to the shear wall for shear force in Z, plus the reinforcement corresponding to the shear wall for torsion. In this area, we can observe the torsion model that is being used for each case. If, for example, we use model A for a circular cross-section, although we've seen that for a circular cross-section it's better to use the automatic mode so that the values of torsion AK, the effective thickness, and the effective perimeter perfectly coincide with the values of the circumference, we'll have to choose the automatic model for torsion. Because if we use the type A model, the program will introduce a series of shear walls. In this example, it would include 8. And to do so, our stirrup will be, according to the formula, the one that corresponds to the shear wall for shear force in Y, plus 2 times the corresponding torsion. And the same for Z. In the first tab sheet, if we click on the Result Combination button, we can either create one or modify the existing one. In this case, we'll see that the parameterized cross-section will always have an Asw1 for the design of the reinforcements, and here is where the formula will appear. This formula can be typed in manually or by using the lower buttons for its creation. In this example, if we had 3 shear walls, one in Z, one in Y, and one for torsion, that were independent of one another, this type of formula could be made. For the colon, it can either be typed in, or we can type Alt so that the program goes ahead with the formula. This slash mark corresponds to the operator O. So we'd have the shear reinforcement of our shear wall in Z, or the same in Y, and if necessary, a plus operator would appear, which we'll take a closer look at in the static course, or the shear reinforcement associated with our torsion.